Even just you saying it, it kind of gets me choked up. It's like, I mean, I was 17, and I remember, like, you know, you know, I remember, like, my mom coming into my room in the morning and being like, you know, honey, Kurt Cobain just died. And I just lost it, you know? I lost it. And it was like, I have to go to fucking school now?
They did not play according to the rules. And they came at a time when the rules were strangling the music. I think they just blew the 80s nonsense apart. They knocked Michael Jackson off the charts. What better metaphor for what he could have accomplished? He had so much to give, and he had so much left to write. And I think in a way, and I don't mean this speciously at all, that I think he was the closest that his generation came to a John Lennon, in that, you know, he was writing very much from the heart, very directly, and he didn't play according to the rules. And the thing that I found really disturbing was that the number of letters that I got after my original review of In Utero, in which I made that reference, people were saying, well, how dare you compare him to John Lennon? I say, you know, look at their life stories, listen to the music. If you don't see the connection, then you're just not paying attention. The thing is, you know, people say, well, you know, what did he say to his audience? Well, he was his audience. In a way, I really feel that this is a great loss. This is not just some, you know, rock star who couldn't handle success and took an easy way out. I think he really shows that there's a generation out there that really has to come to grips with their future. And in many ways, I think a lot of older people and parents really shouldn't look at this as like, you know, this is a rock star, I couldn't handle it. I say, this is your kids. Think about it.